relationship. You sure?
Same time, I had several stressors in my life. One, I was just beginning a brand new job that I wanted very, very badly, and I had to learn it, and I was in an abusive marriage. So those were two stressors.
And your stress is a huge part
of lupus. It will cause you, your lupus, to really manifest itself. And that's what happened to me. And when it happened, I broke out. And I really didn't know what was going on. And because I had just started this new job, and we had to wear different type PPE, they tested me to see if my safety glasses was causing me to break out, or the chemicals at the plant caused me to break out. And I was praying that it didn't, because I didn't want to lose that job.
And which you just retired from.
But those were not the problem. I had a sister that looked at me, and as soon as she looked at me, she said that you had lupus. I know what's wrong with you. You got lupus. And it hurt me so bad that I cried and I cursed her and I told her to stop saying that I didn't have lupus, because I didn't want lupus, because I only knew about two people who had lupus, and they were very, very sick all the time. One girl was walking with a cane, and she had to go to a nursing home, and I just didn't want that. And I went to a dermatologist first, and he told me that's the worst case I've seen, because I was broke all out in my face, all down my arms, in my torso, my stomach, my back, my breast. I was
under
broke
your
out
arms, like how I did.
Under my arm.
No.
But they can make a cosmetic surgery for this.
Yeah, yeah.
they can make it good again.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, most of the time when you're not flaring, your skin does replenish. Like my mom's skin. She hasn't had any cosmetic surgery.
Yeah, I cannot see.
Yeah.
You also,
yeah.
I don't think last time you come.
Yeah, last like time that. I come, so yeah, it wasn't like this.
And it's been a journey for years. And a lot of things happened. I got out of that abusive marriage. I started doing very well on my job. I met a very nice man and married him. then just bringing a daughter up, because I had raised two boys. And I don't know why I could have those two boys and my lupus didn't show up. But when it came to her, I guess all those other stressors that was in my life. And where was I? I forgot.
I had
a few flare-ups, but for the most part, since it got in remission, it stayed in remission, but I stay on it. I make sure I exercise. I try to eat clean as best as I can, and I try to live clean. I don't drink alcohol, and I know it says limit your alcohol, but when it says limit to me, that means
I don't need
to do it. So I do try to keep up with exercise, and I try to always wear sunblock. I always wear sunblock. And in the summer, I'm going to have on sunblocks, sleeves most of the times, umbrella or a hat, sunglasses, because I know what that sun does to me. And certain places, I just can't go and can't do during a certain time of the day, because the sun is so hot and the ultraviolet rays will be on me. But I'm happy with lupus, because my journey with lupus has helped other people with lupus. When I see them, I can tell them what I do, because they look at me and they can't tell that I've got lupus. There was a guy that I worked with. I worked at Procter & Gamble, which turned into Weyerhaeuser, which turned into International Paper. And I had a guy there. His wife died from complications of lupus. And he used to tell me, You know you can get disability. You know you can get disability. You don't have to work this shift work like that. But with my the baby I was girl still without a chance. A circumstance. The world ought to give up, but she's just too hard-headed.